What's up, YouTube? It's the JAY man here. And it is Tuesday, which we all know what that means. It's Corn Cob Tuesday, where we all gather round and light up the old corn cob pipe. Some of us, anyway. Trying to keep the tradition alive and well. And so I'm going to get this thing started here. I don't have a whole lot to cover today. There's not a whole lot to go over today, class. So listen closely. Because a test is upon you. And I'm passing out the cheat sheet. Get that charring light going. And I'm actually breaking in, if you can kind of look in there, see, that's like what the top of a smoked corn cob pipe looks like. And that's kind of what the top of the bowl looks like when you haven't used one. I've actually had this pipe for about 4 years. Probably over 4 years. It came like in a 3-pack of Missouri Meerschaum pipes. And I just haven't used this one yet. I want to say I still got one more other that I haven't used. But I've got so many pipes in my rotation and I don't smoke pipes every day. There just really wasn't a need for to throw another one in rotation. But I thought, what the hell? I've had it for 4 years. And I ain't getting any younger, so I might as well use it while I can. And inside is a little bit of that Seattle Pipe Club plum pudding, which has kind of become my favorite pipe tobacco to date. You can see that pipe tobacco rising up out of the bowl. As it does that, when you're lighting it, it expands. That's why we have our tamper. But you knew that, because we want to tamp it down, keep it nice and flat, keep all the tobacco together, that way it'll continue to burn evenly as well. And that's another reason why I wanted to break this corn cob in. Because I like the plum pudding so much. I was wanting to try it inside of a pipe that never been smoked out of. Because I know there's been lots of people talk about, you know, like a broken, like a pipe that's already been broken is always better. But then some people will say things like, and I know I've mentioned this before, but some people will say things like, if you're gonna say smoke like a cherry aromatic, smoke that out of one designated pipe. Do not smoke cherry aromatic out of every single one of your pipes, because I've heard people say, and for some reason they always say it's with the cherry. I've heard multiple people say it. that once you smoke cherry in it, it will forever kind of resonate and always kind of have that hint of cherry in it. I don't know if that's to be true, because I have smoked cherry out of a couple of different pipes, and I haven't noticed any difference. So I really don't know. I just know that I really enjoyed this blend, and I've had it a few times, and I just wanted to try it inside of a corncob pipe that hadn't been smoked out of, just to see if it makes, you know, any type of difference, or if it makes it taste better, makes it taste worse. And this stuff's got a sweetness to it that is not overly sweet, but it's just right. Right in between that sweet, earthy, just flavors. And it smokes great. I really haven't had no issue with relighting with this stuff. Plus, this stuff just has a smell that, like the secondhand smell to me, just has this wonderful aroma. Like, I would love to, like, if I had a man cave of my own or someplace that was where I could smoke inside, say, like, this stuff just seems like it would make the air phenomenal smelling. A lot of people would disagree, but I don't like a lot of smoke inside either. But I mean, that's why I don't like to smoke inside, because I don't want everything else smelling like it. But I do feel like if I had a man cave, and I might do it then, but this stuff right here just seems like it would smell the air up something great. Like somebody would walk in and go, "Ooh, that smells wonderful." One thing I've noticed about this plum pudding, though, I don't break it up too fine, because it does come in the crumble keg style. I don't break it up too fine, but I break it up fine enough to where it's manageable to do a good pack job on the pipe. But it does burn quick. It goes quick. Like, as great as a flavor as it is, it comes and goes. Because it seems like the pipe sessions I've had with it don't last that long. Like, I can't stretch them 45 minutes. Maybe a half hour. Maybe. Possibly. I mean, I'm already rocking 8 minutes, but I'm also doing a lot of talking. So, of course, it's going to, you know, last longer when you're not puffing. But it is good. One thing I wanted to talk about. I know in one of my last videos, I want to say the last video, I did discuss, I touched upon people that find old pipes and want to do the salt treatment on it, you know, and we had kind of discussed that a little bit. But the thing that I want to discuss is, let's just say, day-to-day pipe maintenance. And that's like, say, after you get done, smoking, having a smoke session, which is really basic and it's very simple, because this is one thing I hadn't covered. I'd covered lighting methods, I had covered packing, smoking, all that good stuff. I haven't talked about how to clean a pipe, or, you know, using pipe cleaners. So
Let me stoke up the fire again. Stoke it up.
Even when this stuff starts to go out, you can stoke that fire right back up, no problem. Put another log on the fire. These people around here drive crazy as hell. Damn, I can't get enough of that. You need to try this, whoever the hell you are that's watching. You need to give this a try. Seattle Pipe, well, because I did a review video on it on my channel. If you haven't seen it, check it out. Seattle Pipe Club Plum Pudding. It's fucking phenomenal. Hello. But we're rocking 11 minutes. Let's get to the lecture at hand. I just brought one of my other corn cobs out here. When I get done having a pipe session, I tend to not waste any. I always smoke my pipe all the way down to nothing. But there's going to be something in there. And that something, people call it dottle. I've heard it called dottle. It's basically just a combination of ash, what was left of your pipe tobacco that did not burn, as well as it could be a little mushy, a little wet from spit, because you are going to create quite a bit of saliva. That's why I spit a lot. You probably noticed that in my videos, that I spit a lot. I don't know if a lot of other people do that, but it makes me salivate. Is that the word, salivate? Makes me spit a lot. So you're going to see a lot of that in there, because even if you look at this right here, what I've been smoking, I don't know, my camera sucks because I got an old style Galaxy phone, but you can see little bubbles in there, condensation from this, just the spit and the moisture. Not just the spit, but the moisture from the smoke and the heat. That's going to go out on me. Ain't nothing I can do. I must teach. Because those that can't do, teach. Okay. So what I do... So you got three things on this check tool right here, and every good piper needs a good check tool. Your tamper, of course, during the smoke session, you're going to be packing it down. There's two other things on here, the poker. That's the poker, that's the spoon. When it comes to the corn cob pipes, you're going to need the poker. Because you're going to need to, and you're not going to be able to see down in there, so... But you're going to need to kind of get down in those little grooves from where the pipe shaft, the wooden pipe shaft that's coming into the bowl, that's protruding through the hole in the side of the bowl. So you're going to need to use this to kind of scrape. Not really scrape, because you want to be easy on the inside of your pipe. But just kind of pick out those particles, and then... you know, and you can just kind of do like that a little bit just to break it up. Maybe use the, you know, use the spoon a little bit just to kind of, you know, and then you can flip it over after you've done that. If you have a cork knocker on an ashtray, you can just do that number right there and get it out. Or what I like to do, I like to just hold it from the side. Just give it a few of these, and all that'll come out. Once you've done that, and any great piper knows you always got to have a good supply of pipe cleaners. You can get like 100 of them for like $3. And I usually use two per pipe session. So if you use two and you do it right, don't waste, you could probably make 100 pipe cleaners, you know, two into 100, 50 bowls. Hell, even if you smoke one a day, that's almost 2 months worth of pipe cleaners. No problem there. I always use two. I try not to use any more than two, but I like to use more than one. So the first thing I do, depending on what pipe I have, because not all pipes are going to be created equal when it comes to how easy it is to get a pipe cleaner, you know, down the stem, down the shaft, all the way to the bowl to where you can see it. The more narrow, you got to use the smaller end. The wider, you can use the bigger end. On these Missouri Meerschaums, you can always use the big end. So you just stick that bad boy down there, stick it all the way in. See, you can see that pipe cleaner in there. It's all the way in there. Sometimes it's easy enough, you can just, I like to spin it, give it a spin, kind of collect all that spit, collect all that ash, all that, you know, kind of, not really nastiness, but just all that bullshit in there. Sometimes it's hard to spin. Good little trick, put a little bend on it, give it a little swirl, get a good clean like that. Pull it out, and I usually do it one more time. I usually do this number. See how I blew some of the pipe cleaner fuzz out of there? Sometimes you'll blow ash out of there too. Just blow it out, it's all good. And then I like to run another one. I usually run at least two. And then what I do is I take these, and they're gonna be a little dirty, but it's all good. I take the same two, I bend them like that. I stick them down in here like so, give it a little spin. Not too much, not too hard. Especially if you're doing your briar, you may be wanting to create a thick layer of cake inside your pipe, so you're not gonna wanna do too much of that with your briars. Corn cobs, I'm not really typically worrying about trying to build cake or keep cake. So I just give it a good little spin around, clean it out real good. And I usually do that with both pipe cleaners. Then I do one of these numbers. Just like so. And depending on how dirty your pipe gets on the outside, you could always get a little, maybe like a dry rag, dry cloth, just kind of clean it. I don't really remove the stems and clean them too much. I do know that over time, if you want, and it's after the pipe is cooled down, you can remove these stems, like the plastic stems, and you know, wash them in soap water, let them soak in soap water, and rinse them out. When they're dry, put them back on there. I haven't had to do that too often. Because like I said, if you use the pipe cleaners and you're taking really good care of your pipes and you're cleaning them like you're supposed to after every session, you and I always clean them directly after the session, you shouldn't have any problems. It's real easy. It's easy peasy, lemon squeezy. So, with that being said, that right there is going to be pipe maintenance after your smoke session, after your pipe session. And I know this has gone out. Still warm though. Nice. But like I said, these check tools, kind of a must for me. Almost rocking 20 minutes. It's like, damn, J.A.Y., man, you sure do talk a lot. Just gotta fast forward, like, hold on, let me see, I'm gonna fast forward a few more minutes, see if he's saying anything interesting. Like, just fast forward to the end of the video. Get to the fucking point already.
Okay.
Anyways, that's all I'm going to say. As always, everybody, happy Corn Cob Tuesday to ya. Hit that subscribe if you're not subscribed. Hit that like. Leave a comment. Say something. Or choose to say nothing. Choice is yours. Stay smoking. Hit them with a peace out.